Welcome, 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 my dear brothers and sisters, once again to this special program. You know, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You must believe in the gospel of the kingdom of God. Time will delay no longer. He who said, I am coming soon, is going to come very soon. Prepare to meet the Lord your God. So, what's up, Pastor Ji?
Oh, I've been just pondering since our last time, the fellowship that we had about the things we were talking, you know. And something you just said just now, Sadhuji, that the kingdom of God is at hand. That's another mystery, no?
Yes.
Because I was reminded just now, but I do have a question for you.
So before you ask me that question, I have something to ask you.
Okay.
I heard that your wife also wants to come and join in this program with us. And she was insisting that you take her with you. But how is it that you came without her? How do you manage to pacify her and make her stay at home?
Well, I didn't really pacify her. I told her that I had other programs to do.
Oh.
Once I'm done with that, I will have her join us.
Oh, I see. Okay. So that's how you...
That's how I pacified her.
Okay, all right.
You know, just like she's like a lioness, you know.
Yes.
I have to just very gently pacify her.
Okay, all right.
But I was pondering on this kingdom thing.
Tell me.
You know, when Jesus came back out of the wilderness and he went to the synagogue and he read the Isaiah chapter 61, verse 1 and 2. But the mystery is that he never finished part 2. So that brings us again to the end time. Because part 2, at the end it says, the vengeance and judgment. But in the beginning he says, the kingdom of God is at hand.
Right.
And then he saved the rest because it is going to happen. So that's another mystery, no?
The kingdom of God is for salvation and it is for vengeance. So the first part of the kingdom is for salvation. The second part of the kingdom is when the king comes to reign.
Yes.
You are so correct, because the Lord, Yeshua, on purpose refrain from reading that last portion of that scripture, because that time is for a future time.
Right.
That time was not when he first came.
Right.
He first came to offer himself as a sacrifice for sin. But the second time when he comes to reign as king and to take vengeance is not that time. That's for the future time.
Right.
You know, I was going to talk to you about, remember on the very first episode, you mentioned about how your heart tore when your daughter was given away, like the father of the bride.
Yes.
Although she's not staying too far away, yet you feel the separation.
Yes.
And then you were wondering how God the Father would have felt when the Lord Yeshua was sent. So that one comment that you made us ponder and meditate on the various mysteries that are related to it. To bring that topic to one conclusion, there is another aspect that I wanted to share with you. No? See, one aspect of the mystery is God separating himself into two.
Yes.
The Son is someone who comes out.
Yes.
That's what the Son, the title Son, is all about. Not like he's a son in the sense like how we have children, begotten, that came out. Like he came out of the bosom of the Father. So it's more of a title rather than a name or a reference to being born. Mm-hmm. You have something to add?
You know, I'm just pondering, I don't know if this is the right time to ask this question, because it just raised my curiosity.
Okay.
So, the Father, we see the Father, and the Son comes out of the Father. So I was pondering, so now that we have received Jesus as our Savior, and He is inside of us, so it's almost like the, when we talk about the word, the manifested sons of God coming out. It's really Christ Himself was changing us, where there will come a time when He says He will reveal the manifested sons. He will actually reveal Himself, no?
Yes.
It'll be that same separation, like,
yes,
that took place from the Father to the Son. And then for us, being in Christ, coming out as His sons, you know?
You are right, and you are not so right.
Okay.
You are right in what you just said, but for the manifested Son's nature in us to be separated, to come out as a manifestation of Christ,
right,
Yeshua, that separation that God had separated Himself into becoming the Son. Now they must take place within us.
Yes.
So that separation for the Christ life to come out so that it can be that manifested Son.
Yes.
It must come out, right?
Yes.
Come out from where?
From the Christ within.
Nay.
No.
Come out from the
world.
I factor.
Ah. Okay.
The I inside you.
Ah.
The I must die.
Okay.
I'll give you a clue.
Okay.
You want to say something before I give you the clue?
No, I was going to say, long time ago, you shared something with me.
Ah, please.
I would like the audience to hear about Sadhu Sundar Singh and Maharishi's example that you shared with me that really blessed me. I know the audience will be blessed.
You know, the great saint who lives on the Himalayan mountains called Maharishi. Oh, by the way, speaking of that, it would be better for you to read the complete version of this story called the Maharishi of Kailash. You can see that on our screen right now, or you can order it from our web store. You'll be so blessed, tremendously beyond the word called bless, by reading that book. Won't you agree?
Yes.
Okay. So, Sadhu Sundar Singh, the blessed saint of God, he met this Maharishi. He wanted to know his name. So he said, when I was living in the world, I had a name. But now, I am dead to myself. The I no longer exists. So now I am a son. Because when I was I had sin. S-I-N. Now I am a son. S-O-N. So the O, I'm dead. I'm nothing.
Yeah.
I'm nobody now. The I doesn't live anymore. When the I dies, he becomes a son.
Yes.
That means you are no more you.
Yes.
Zero.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we must come to that self. Die from the I.
Yes.
Okay, now I'll give you the clue.
Okay.
I see that you already have opened your Bible. Please turn with me to Galatians chapter 2. In Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. See here, first say, I am crucified.
Yes.
There he say, but I live. So there's a difference between the two I's, no? Isn't it?
Yes.
Yet not I. I live, but yet not I. But Christ. So that I who lives is a Christ I.
Yes.
Who lives in me, and the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loves me and gave himself for me.
Mm.
So the first I factor dies, and comes the other I, is the Christ I.
Christ I.
So when the Christ I comes, then the manifested Son of God nature will begin to manifest and reveal. Unless that happens. See, I'll show you another scripture.
Can I just share this, Sadhuji?
Yes, please.
In the Amplified, I like the way it's written, where it says, I have been crucified with Christ.
Mm-hmm.
But this is the key. It says, in him, I have shared his crucifixion.
Mm. Good.
You know?
Yes.
And that identification of that crucifixion, you know, many don't really identify with that. They just identify with the forgiveness of sin.
Exactly. Exactly. See, can you turn your Bible to Romans chapter 8? In Romans chapter 8, here it says, like what you mentioned about the manifested sons of God, in verse 19, for the earnest expectation of the creation waits for the manifestation of the sons of God. So this is waiting. So this waiting is dependent on, look at verse 21. Because the creation itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation groans in pain. See the corruption. It is the I factor that is the corruption.
Yeah.
So once this I dies, then there comes a separation. The divine life of God that is within us, like what it says in the epistle of 1 Peter chapter 1, no? The divine life.
Yes.
We receive the divine nature of God. It is enclosed within. The glory that will manifest from the divine nature is dependent on the degree to which we are willing to yield to the Holy Spirit and die to self.
Yes. Yes.
So the more we die, the more it will get separated and it will stand out to be on its own.
Yes.
But when we don't die, the self rules more. That glory cannot be revealed, cannot be manifested. Like it says here, see, in verse 18. For I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Revealed in us because of the manifestation of the sons of God.
Wow. Yes, I see.
So this is all hidden together, like the glory being covered by a kernel of flesh, you know, like the transfiguration that took place.
Yes.
See, the glory of God that was manifested on the Lord Yeshua has always been there.
Yes.
But it's covered by the flesh. But when the flesh removed, then the glory manifested. What you see there is what is written here.
Yeah.
When the bondage of corruption is removed.
Removed, yes. Yes.
Destroyed or crucified, then the manifestation of the glory of the sons of God will be revealed.
Yes. And you know that scripture, first I was thinking, you know, the simple way to some understanding that I just received. When you were saying that the divine light that's within us. So the I, the selfish part, it's like a lunar eclipse. We are hiding the light.
Yes.
You know, by ourself. And the other thing is where it says that the earth groans. Because the earth knew what it was like when God created it, no?
Exactly.
And after Adam's sin and all that, it's groaning to go back to what God created.
So that we'll call the iPride.
Yes, the iPride. The iPad, the iPhone, the iPride. Yes.
You know, that reminds me of humor. Once I went to a church in Singapore and I told them, today I'm going to share with you about e-spirit. Everybody were looking, what is this e-spirit? Everybody was up. That church, they respect me very highly, yeah. You know. So they thought, oh, some great revelation this man of God has brought today. E-spirit. I said, I'm going to talk to you about e-spirit today. Everybody were looking at me with great attention. And you can see the look on their faces now. Great eager, they all were looking. And also question mark on their faces. I said, you have never heard of e-spirit before? Everybody like, scratching their head. Oh, I said, you have email, you have ETK, and you have e-spirit, evil spirit.
Only you come up with this. Next time Apple has a question, you know, they should call you. No, we already came up, no?
What?
With the
iPride.
iPride?
Anyway, we are living in glorious days.
Yes.
Where many, many wonderful mysteries of God will be revealed. Especially, you know, again and again, I feel in my heart, these mysteries will be made known to all the world. All the world meaning, like what I shared with you in one of the previous program, in Revelation chapter 5, where it says, things under the earth,
yes,
and in the sea, and that are in them, they all must hear the mysteries of God. So why they need to hear?
Well, I think it has to do with that scripture, you know, where it says everything is drowning. So that could be one aspect, because, you know, the corruption, because the sin in the earth, under the earth, in the sea.
So let's call it the I hear.
I hear.
Okay?
Okay?
I hear. But I must honestly say, I do not fully know the implication and the interpretation of that. But something deep in my spirit, I sense, I perceive that every creature in the sea and in it and on the earth and under the earth must all, because it says that every creature must come and stand before the judgment throne of God.
Correct.
So before the judgment is been passed, everyone given a fair chance to hear the mysteries of God, the gospel of the kingdom of God.
Yes.
And then whatever other things that are mysteries that need to be communicated, the unearthing of the mysteries. I believe in the coming days, God will be gracious to make known to us His
mysteries. Yeah.
This is all necessary, you know. Many things we don't know.
Right.
For example, see Pastor G, please turn to Revelation chapter 10. You know, this angel, mighty angel who came down from heaven. Look at verse 2. Why must he put the right foot on the sea and the left foot on the land? Why can't he put both his foot in one place?
Well, because I think again it goes back to the scripture we were reading before.
Right?
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
They are linked.
Yes.
See? Because, let's look at chapter 5. In chapter 5, there are every creature that is in heaven.
Yes.
So that is one realm.
Yeah.
Then on the earth and under the earth.
Under the
that
earth.
Means two. One into two realm.
Right.
Part A, part B. And then C.
right? Or three.
No. Three? Three AB.
AB, yeah.
Two AB, three AB, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And here, he is clothed with a cloud. Mm-hmm. Cloud and rainbow are associated with things in heaven.
Correct.
Right?
Right.
So, all the three realms are connected here.
Yes.
So, this scripture is really have a link to him.
Yeah.
So, the scroll that he has in his hand, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. which contains the mysteries of God, is something that is to be revealed and manifest to these three realms.
Yes. The heaven realm, the sea realm, the land realm. Yes.
Something that he has, when it is revealed, made known, it will be to all those three realms. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That which is in heaven, mm-hmm. that which is on earth, mm-hmm. and that which is in under, mm-hmm. the sea. All the three realms, mm-hmm. they will have to hear mm-hmm. the mysteries of God. Mm-hmm. Because even the beings in heaven, they don't know everything.
Yes.
You know? There are even many mysteries. I do recall now an incident. Mm-hmm. You know, several years ago, I was invited to speak at a conference in Louisiana. Mm-hmm. And on the day that I arrived and I was waiting on God, I was visited by four angels. Mm-hmm. And the chief among them said, and he revealed to me about the powers of the age to come. Mm-hmm. This is another wonderful teaching that you must receive and hear. You can order it from our website, the information of which you are seeing on the screen right now. And the statement he made was, the world has not seen the power of the Holy Spirit yet.
Yes.
Not even us in heaven. Mm-hmm. I was astounded when he made that statement. No? Mm-hmm. Even we in heaven have not seen the awesome power of the Holy Spirit yet.
Wow.
So, by that statement, it shows there is a mystery about the Holy Spirit
yeah.
that even the beings in heaven do not know yet.
Yes, yes.
And look at that. The scripture says, God dwells in unapproachable light, mm-hmm. which means even the angels cannot approach there.
Yeah.
So, there's some mysteries about God
yes.
that even they do not know yet.
Yes.
So, even the many, many different realms in heaven, that beings in one realm do not know about the beings in another realm.
Yeah.
So, that mystery, or for example, let me mm-hmm. put to you like this. Do you know how our life will be in heaven?
No.
It's not told.
Right.
Forget about life in heaven. Life in the millennium, what do we know?
Not much.
Nothing. Scriptures are silent.
Yep.
So that is a mystery.
Yes.
So that must be taught to us, isn't it?
Right. Right.
Okay, life in heaven. It's not going to be just playing a harp by the river, no?
River, no.
In the sweet...
Bye.
No. It's not going to be like that. No. Are we going to spend eternity just playing harp?
Yeah.
It'll be boring, no?
Yes, very boring, yeah.
See? But heaven is far more greater, far more vast than what our finite mind has ever understood or thought about. Mm-hmm. There's much more.
Yes.
So all that is in that scroll.
Yes.
Once he reveals that scroll and give it to a prophet mm-hmm. or a prophetic company, mm-hmm. then that prophetic company's job is to broadcast,
reveal
it, make it known to all the people of the earth, to all nations, and to all languages. Mm-hmm. Once that is set up, put in place, then this revelation will be made known.
Yeah.
Then everybody will get to know.
Yeah.
So, unfortunately, Pastor G, we have to say goodbye.
I have to save my question till we meet again.
Please.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
Don't be worried. Don't be sad.
No, this
in
is
the sweet,
sweet bye and bye.
Bye bye. And a goodbye to all of you.
dear viewers from Spain. Please send us your testimonies and feedback if you are blessed by this program. Email ID atv.spanish@angeltv.org.